47 very different women of rock are featured in this special issue, from Joni Mitchell to Cher to Pink. But it wasn't easy to choose who should grace the cover. The last cover girls, Tina Turner, Courtney Love, and Madonna, are a tough act to follow.
Consecutive.
Yeah, they all consecutive.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I mean, the match.
Still, Rolling Stones editors believe they've picked three rock icons who are up to the challenge.
This is a wide range of performers. Britney Spears, for many years now, one of the biggest performers in pop music.
Thank you, Mary. We're coming with Bill.
Mary J. Blige, queen of hip-hop soul, someone who has been making records for a decade.
A little bit of big noise, that's it.
Shakira, one of the new breakout stars of the last year, and a woman who uses everything in her music, pop, rock, dance, soul.
And together, Rolling Stone says these women create a powerful portrait of what's happening now in popular music.
Shakira, lean in a little bit.
In late August, the three superstars met at a Manhattan photo studio for the cover shoot. And afterwards, I sat down with them to talk about being a woman in the rock business today.
That's it.
I did this 5 years ago. It was Tina Turner, Madonna, and Courtney Love.
Wow.
This is the next time they do it, and it's Mary J. Blige, Shakira, and Britney Spears. What does that mean to you?
It's very flattering. Yeah. There's too many rugs and legendary issues, so I almost couldn't believe that I was going to be on the cover.
Madonna and Tina Turner is like, oh my, you know, we did something. We've accomplished something, you know, we're somebody.
And like the first three legendary divas, these women are also giants in the music industry, with a combined tally of almost 50 million albums sold in the U.S. But do they feel their trip to the top was any tougher because they're women?
Is it women versus men in this business? Do you ever feel that way?
I don't feel that way because I don't look at my life that way. I respect myself as a woman, so I demand respect from you.
We do have to learn to have really thick skin. Just, it's the nature of the business, and it makes you grow up a lot faster, and you just, you know, you gotta be strong because people will run over you, you know. To me, the toughest thing has never been my condition as a woman. If I ever had troubles dealing with my career, was because I started this when I was very young.
Still, there are those who say that in the music business, women are pushed to put more emphasis on their image than men. Sex sells. And for these women, that can create a tricky balancing act.
I have to be careful with what I show to children, with what I say to children, because automatically, whether people know it or not, once you're on television, you have become someone's role model. Because a lot of children don't have anyone to look up to.
Is that fair? Do you all agree with that? The role model side of this?
Any popular, any famous person has a direct or indirect responsibility or influence, you know, over the masses. It's just really what a role model is to you as the individual. Like, what do you want to feed off for your public, you know?
They're going to imitate you the way you look, but do you also spend a lot of time thinking about to imitate the way you live?
When I go on stage and I perform, that's me being an entertainer, and that's me doing what I love to do. As far as the way I live, you know, I try to keep a lot of that to myself.
So what advice do they have for the next Britney, the next Mary, and the next Shakira?
I would say never doubt yourself and always believe in yourself. And don't care what people think and just go for it, you know.
I would have to say if you're a teenager, please finish high school. Make God first and final and listen to your mother.
Be really stubborn because that helps in this business. And surround yourself by your loved ones.
Words of wisdom from three rock musicians who prove that girl power really packs a punch.